Queensryche?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I just finished the first leg, and we go back on the second leg next week.
So what's it like now? You know, you used to play a series of clubs and stuff like that, and now you're playing a series of arena after arena.
Nice, very nice. It's a lot easier. It's a lot funner. It's quite enjoyable, and we're lucky too because a lot of the shows are general admission too, which is good for us. And you know, people with Queensryche, the crew and the band, they've been real good to us. So a lot of times you hear about bands being support and having a lot of problems. We've had no problems whatsoever, so it's like real easy.
Are the guys from Queensryche into suicidal tendencies?
I don't know how much, but
you've seen them watching the show.
They are now. No, they're real cool and stuff. And I mean, they, you know, understand a little bit our situation, you know, and about needing a break and stuff. And I mean, if it wasn't for them, I mean, no one's given us a break before, and I don't think anybody else would have. And so it's nice, and it's good to be able to play in front of people and people that never heard you before, and to see the reaction you get.
You guys also did something which is kind of cool. I guess before the concerts, you have like this is one of the flyers of like a tailgate party you guys have where you give out free pizza and free sodas and get to meet suicidal tendencies. Is that your guys' idea?
Actually, it was Mark Ryder's, I think, from the label and stuff. And they know how we've always like gone out in the crowds and stuff and don't really have a problem with people. And a lot of bands are like kind of scared of people and stuff. So, and the football games and the baseball games, they have the tailgate parties. They say, why don't we just do something like that where it makes it convenient and the people that autographs are important for and all that stuff, they can do that.
And it was guaranteed free pizza, so.
Yeah, exactly.
So you know they'll
And when
there.
The Moonlight Mission is closed on, you know, Thursdays, drop on by, pizza's good.
We'll be back talking to Mike and Robert of Suicidal Tendencies after these words. And right now we're also gonna take a look back in time with a much younger Mike Muir at one of their first videos.
But still ugly.
That was a clip from this live version of War Inside My Head, which is, I guess, on the home video, Lights, Camera, Suicidal, right?
Mm-hmm.
And you guys did that, I guess, right in a big record store parking lot, just in front of all the kids and everything.
Yeah, they announced it as an in-store, and then
we went out there and took our amps. And
started. We're supposed to have been able to play six songs, but the police pulled the plug after four. But
Now, I also understand you recently were shooting another video for the song Alone.
Last night, yeah.
So tell us about that. Give us a little preview since we don't have it yet.
We got these little rats on steroids with gremlin hairdos, which are pretty bad. It's one of those ones that, I guess, actually, I'm going to have to see it. I was a little worried before, but I think it's going to be pretty good. And hopefully a lot of people won't understand it. Yeah, because that means we did it right.
If they don't understand it, you're doing
things that
right.
People understand, then you got to give it up. Be a politician or something.
When you see the video, you'll see Dr. Doolittle's circus tent. And that'll make a big impression on people.
Dr. Doolittle's circus tent?
Oh yeah, seriously.
Well, I'll be waiting for that. Yeah. Now we're gonna be showing the video for Send Me Your Money, and I know it's summer, and people are probably thinking I was gonna stop talking about hockey, but I understand that you have a couple cameos in this video.
Yes, we gotta... Stop it!
We're discussing a nervous habit of Mike.
It's not a nervous habit. I think it's a quite refreshing.
You see him,
you just kicked me.
See, that's
Brian Leach, James Patrick, New York Rangers, hockey.
There you go. That's the people that's in the video. And let's just take a look at the video right now, shall we? Here's Suicidal Tendencies with Send Me Your Money. On the latest Suicidal Tendencies record, Lights, Camera, Revolution, which I imagine is your best record in sales so far, right?
Think so.
So Suicidal Tendencies fans are growing. There's definitely getting more and more of them out there.
Yeah. Selling more records than Michael Jackson.
The talk radio guy. But anyways, back in January, you guys opened up for Jane's Addiction, which was quite a different show. And it seems like right now, I know that Warrior Soul is opening up for NWA. And it seems like there's a lot of pairings of different types of bands. I mean, do you see a lot of that going on right now?
for us, it's like, you know, we just do our thing and we don't really care about it. We're not trying to fit in any specific way. We've been labeled so many different things. And it doesn't really matter, you know, people are people, music is music, you like it, you don't, you know. You don't have to like all kinds of food, just because you like lasagna don't mean you have to like spaghetti, you know. Mm-hmm. It's like, that's the whole thing, take it for what it is, and if you don't appreciate it, fine, and that's our thing. If something's good and you can get something out of it, it doesn't matter. Everyone's too worried about fitting in, whether it's music or anything, you know. People need to relax. They get so upset. It's
like, when you're playing at the arenas, and I mean, you hit the stage and there's like 9,000 people in front of you or something, do you find it hard to relate to all the people and just like stay in touch with the audience? Because like I said, I've seen you guys play tons of times, and definitely the crowd has a good time, but I've only seen you in front of smaller crowds.
I think that we feel more, actually a little more comfortable playing in front of the arena crowds. I mean, the stages are larger for one, so you can just do your thing, and I mean, it's like a playground out there, and we have a really good time. And basically,
stop moving.
No, as far as performing, I think it's a lot easier for us to do that arena tour.
It's a lot more enjoyable too, and it's cool. It's like, I mean, before people, I don't know.
It's easier to jump in the audience too. When you're the riser.
Well, like I said, these are a great band to see live. Definitely check them out. And how much longer does the tour go on for?
Goes till August.
Till August?
Uh-huh.
And tomorrow night you're going to be in Birmingham, Alabama, and Monday night in Huntsville, and Tuesday in Memphis, Tennessee. And if you're in those towns and you're going to go see the Queensryche show, show up early. Definitely check Suicidal Tendencies out. Very good band. Thanks again for showing up.
Thank you very much.
And right now, let's see a video from Queensryche.
Yeah,
work on the foot thing by the time you come back here next time. Right now, it's time to take a look at a video from Queensryche. Here is Jet City Woman.